It is a sport where young girls are asked to grow up fast, to summon poise and elegance beyond their years. But oh, how we've seen them mature, becoming graceful champions. Their youthful achievements forever etched in ice.
We first saw her when she was 14 years old, and now she's 19 in the full flower of her championship form.
Hasn't she got a lot of moxie?
Good for her.
What a moment for this young lady.
Tonight, another young woman we've watched grow up stands on the verge of greatness.
Well, I think Michelle Kwan Raitt is probably one of the top three skaters in all of U.S. history.
You name people like Dorothy Hamill and Peggy Fleming and those, and you know, you have to put her name right in there with all those, the greatest skaters in the world.
It's a challenge to try to stay on top, to try to be number one.
3 years from now, in this very same place, her quest for Olympic gold will begin. But first, in this sport where much is asked of young women, Michelle Kwan must call upon her poise, her elegance. Will she earn her third national title and be celebrated as one of skating's all-time best? Salt Lake City, the capital of Utah, lit up and alive tonight. While an Olympic controversy has enveloped this community, the nation's finest figure skaters look to put that scandal on ice. And we welcome you to the Delta Center for the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. Earlier today in the men's competition, Michael Weiss captured his first U.S. men's title. And hi, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. Later tonight, we'll have live coverage of the ladies' free skate, with Michelle Kwan trying to win her third gold medal against a field that includes a number of young guns who could be right back here in Salt Lake 3 years from now competing for an Olympic gold medal. And speaking of the Olympics, the largest scandal in the modern history of those games continues. Leslie Visser will have more later in our broadcast. Right now we turn our attention to the pairs free skate and welcome in Olympic champion Dick Button. It's going to take all of that Ivy League education to sort this one out.
Well, can you imagine a day, a daytime soap opera transformed into primetime sports television? Well, you know, that's what we've got here tonight. Kyoko Ina, one half of the pair in second place, was champion last year with Jason Dungeon. But she gave Jason the old heave-ho to skate with John Zimmerman. However, Jason is here as the coach of none other than the Hartzells, who are in the lead after the short program. Could this be sweet revenge? Ah, the plot thickens. And you know, Peggy Fleming knows that there are no clear favorites here.
Well, that's true, Dick. You know, the title is up for grabs. And for most people at home watching, it's hard to imagine spending every minute of your day with your brother or sister. But that's just what two of our top teams do. Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler and our leaders Danielle and Steve Hartzell have an advantage as brother and sister. They've been together since birth, and because of simple genetics, they also move the same way. To overtake the Hartzells, Kyoko and John, who have been together for only 8 months, will have to get in sync and rely on their individual experience.
And Peggy, here are the way things stand heading into the free skate. Danielle and Steve Hartzell trying to win their first gold medal. They're the leaders right now. Ina and Zimmerman in second place. Handy, Benabos trying to edge out Stiegler and Stiegler for the bronze medal here.
Representing the University of Delaware Figure Skating Club in Newark, Delaware, let's have a warm welcome now for Laura Handy and J. Cole Benabos.
And now taking the ice first, 18-year-old Laura Handy and 21-year-old J. Paul Benabos in third place.
Well, they are so surprised and thrilled to be in third place. I just hope nerves won't play a factor for them. They have a lot of energy. They're opening with a triple twist. Nice height. Or throw triple salchow. Oh, beautiful spring in the air. Nice tight turns, straight legs. And they're side by side, triple toe loops.
A great start. The music Sleeping Beauty by Tchaikovsky and Concerto for Orchestra and Violin, also by Tchaikovsky. Both their ages, their physical structure, their skating abilities are very good sync. A star lift, one-armed star lift, and turn out and drop down.
Nice and smooth on the exit.
Side-by-side double axles. And a throw, triple. She double-footed it, but she gets wonderful height, and she has lovely straight legs and completes her revolution before she lands the jump. It is not sneaked-out revolution. There's a lightness to this pair and an elegance to them that even though they are very young and really not very experienced, it shows that they have rather wonderful potential.
Good unison on the side-by-side combination spin. They were turning right in sync.
This only their second trip to the Senior Nationals. They finished in sixth place a year ago, but they captured a silver medal at the Junior World Championships recently.
A little bit of a stumble there on his part, causing disruption in the flow of that spin. That plus the fact that in their side-by-side double axles, she did only a single axle will hurt them, but I wouldn't think a great deal. They left that lift out. It was to have been a one-arm helicopter lift. See, they're not back onto sync yet. They're losing. They've lost the excitement that they had at the beginning of the program.
I don't know if that's due to being exhausted or not good training habits, but they started out so well. They seem to be slowing down, making little mistakes.
She's dropping into that in not a very good position. And a two-foot landing. I think there's something that's been very upsetting to them. Something's wrong. Something was wrong at the end, and I don't know what it was, but they just completely fell apart after a certain moment that about four or five elements back, it was not good.
It was good. They were right in sync. It was beautifully done.
The judges marks for Laura Handy and Jay Paul.
And now there'll be two sets of marks, of course, for technical merit and presentation. This free skate worth two-thirds of the overall score. First set, 5.2 to 5.7.
5 points.
And certainly creditable marks. Points. They're sitting there, by the way, with Ron Ludington, one of the icons of the field of ice, dancing and pair skating, and Tracy Politis. And they have a very interesting group of people who have put together this program. Very much the Russian and classical influence.
But lower scores now for presentation, Dick. 4.9 up to 5.4 for Laura Handy and J. Paul Benevos after a great start. And when we come back, the team in second place, Yoko Ina and John Zimmerman, plenty of experience, but not together. For them, the biggest challenge comes from within.
Ourselves are definitely our toughest competition. We're not looking at other skaters thinking, oh, we have to beat them, or oh, watch out for them. Right now, we're still learning about what we can do, what our ability is, and we set goals for ourselves. And we say, okay, if we can get through 80% of the program and do that somewhat decently, we'll be happy.
On behalf of the Skating Club of New York in New York City and the Birmingham Figure Skating Club in Birmingham, Alabama, a warm welcome now for Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman.
Welcome back to Salt Lake City. The Pairs Championship continues as Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman take the ice. They are in second place.
The music, Phantom of the Opera, Andrew Lloyd Webber.
I think each one of their competitions they participated in is a big lesson and a tool for them to find their strength as a pair.
They both admitted they had the jitters the other night in the short program.
And they are opening with side-by-side triple toe loops. Here they go. Oh, very nice. Very solid.
He has had difficulty with his triple jumps before. He seems to be conquering that problem. I've got to tell you, when you throw a gal into the air and twist her and she does a split in the middle of it and then try to set her down on that eighth of an inch wide blade, it isn't easy.
And that's that timing and rhythm that they need to connect with one another. They've only been together 8 months.
He's the one that's been having trouble technically. She's very strong from a technical point of view, but his drama and flair are outstanding.
That was a beautiful overhead lift. That was supposed to be a throw triple loop, and it ended up just being a double.
Spins.
Tamara Masvina knows that their styles and their rhythm are different, but she said she's going to work with them and use that contrast.
And says there is no rush. They're pointing towards this city, but the year 2002 and the Olympics.
Now here comes the throw triple salka that they planned. Was a double.
And that timing just wasn't there.
I'm quite sure that there's some problem here also, because they would not be backing off these moves if everything was all right. That simple fall, I don't think, would have extended this long.
Oh, extension in her upper body and her arm on that lift.
She's always had a great back. They seem to be more on track now than they were earlier.
This is a nice sequence. It really, I think, accentuates their style so nicely.
An interesting progression through these programs. Both the earlier pair of Handy and Bina boys, and now Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, seem to have had disruptions in the program that just took away their energy. Tamara knows what's happened.
Tamara Moskovina, the famous Russian coach, also coach of the world champions, reigning Olympic champions, and there's John's family. That's Laura, and on the right is mom and dad. Got to be disappointing right now, though.
It was Now watch here as she toe picks, splits, beautiful position, the wonderful turning, but she's leaning quite far around. Now watch here as he sets her down. She sets her foot on his left foot, and that doesn't get it between his feet, and that causes the problem. Now look right here. Watch as she toe picks from between his feet. Now watch his left foot right there. She steps right in front of it, knocks them down, and they disappear. What a pity.
Kyoko Ina, the two-time and reigning champion of this event, although that was with her former partner Jason Dungeon, of course. Tonight has been much tougher.
There they are with Tamara Moskvina and her husband. And these marks are not what they expected. A markdown for that major fall, and I think somewhere along the line for the slowdown in the program, the lack of energy. That's reflected in this mark.
The presentation marks, Dick, 5.3 up to 5.7 in terms of those that have skated in the free skate. Ina and Zimmerman, the leaders.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tiffany Stiegler and Johnny Stiegler.
She is only 15 years of age, and he just a year older. Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler, the brother-sister team, they are in fourth place with an opportunity to perhaps move to the podium.
The music, Giselle, Adolphe Adam. They work with Irina Rodnina and Elena Cherkaskaya, the great Russian, Irina Rodnina, the great Russian pair skating champion. And you can see the Russian influence already in their style.
Very dramatic facial expressions on Tiffany's part. She is an absolute doll. She really sells this team.
That's because it represents the opening scene, the mad scene. Oh, again.
They almost had the same trouble that Kyoko and John had. Now this throw, triple loop.
Oh,
beautiful. Wow.
Extraordinary height. That was just wonderful. The way, the height and the flow and the speed of that. Dangerous is all get out, but when it works, it is spectacular. And that was side by side, double axles. Ah.
Tiffany and Johnny with a terrific debut at the Nationals a year ago, finished in fourth place.
Look at this beautiful position in the air.
And the way she turns out her foot, stretched up in a star position.
Makes it look more extended, more pointed of the pointed toe.
And he singled his side-by-side loop.
Remember, even though the U.S. can send three teams to the World Championships in pairs, the Stieglers cannot go because Tiffany did not turn 15 by July of last year.
That spiral position on her was first rate, as is this death spiral.
position is so pretty in that pair spin arch in the back. They have some really fine moments in their program.
Throw triple Salchow. It's again the lift and the height, the straight, stretched, tight legs. Their speed and stroking, their line and position, something we see little of in the singles to this extent. Doesn't she remind you a bit of the very young Irina Rodnina? And I'm sorry, the very young Ekaterina Gordieva.
She has that magical face.
And also the same long-limbed look. Ah, he singled that side-by-side Salchow.
Nice unison on this combination spin.
Very nice turned over position. Now, and this final forward inside death spiral. Watch her feet. Look at her feet, the stretch, the point of the toe. Very nice. She has beautiful legs.
This pair has such wonderful potential. They are just such a joy to watch.
Irina Rodnina, 10 times the world champion, 3 times Olympic champion with 2 different partners, a force and a source of Russian pair skating. There's John.
Linda and John, the Stieglitz parents, and Tiffany and Johnny from Manhattan Beach, California, the novice national champions, the junior national champions.
And now look at this throw. That, first of all, look in the loop position, back outside it. Now watch the height. Look at her legs, the stretch, the tightness of it. He throws her aggressively and gets slightly out of control, but that's part for the course.
The judges, Mark Spohr, Tiffany Stiegler, and Johnny Stiegler for
Tiffany and Johnny, along with Irina Rodnina on the right, and Yelena Cherkoskaya right next to them. The first set of marks for technical merit.
And those are you know, standard for the mistakes that they made. They're a very young pair. They're still immature. They have wonderful potential, wonderful elegance and line. Thank you, Elena Cherkaskaya and Rodnina, Irina Rodnina.
And now for presentation, 5.1 to 5.6, and it places them in third place in terms of those that have already skated tonight.
And I think that reflects some of the line and positions that they have.
And we welcome you back inside the Delta Center for a look at our mobile update of the current standings. Ina and Zimmerman in first place, Andy and Vinovos in second, and Johnny and Tiffany Stiegler in third place.
Danielle Hartzell and Steve Hartzell.
But here are the leaders after the short program. It's their gold medal to win or lose. 18-year-old Danielle Hartzell and her 21-year-old brother Steve.
Tchaikovsky, and later, Man in the Iron Mask.
And Danielle and Steve have worked very hard over this past year, and I do see a lot of improvement, but they still muscle a lot of their skating. They're very powerful, good height, good flow over that split triple twist. Trouble on those side-by-side triple toe loops.
But they were basically okay. You know, just they were completed. Even though there was a little struggle on the landings. Throw triple Salchow.
Nice.
And notice the difference between
this and the previous pair of Stiegler and Stiegler. This is a far more solid technical performance.
And this is a move. They invented the heart attack lift. She practically does a handstand. Gives her parents a little heart attack on the side, too.
Side-by-side double axles. Very strong, very powerful.
I think she singled hers.
Danielle and Steve in a position where they have to win this free skate to unseat Ina and Zimmerman at the top. And don't forget Dick's soap opera, Jason Dungeon, one of the coaches for Danielle and Steve, the former partner of Kyoko Ina.
Note how similar they are, both in physical structure and type and style of skating.
Nice, smooth transitions in this pair spin.
But they somehow have to yet develop in artistry and elegance. They have plenty of good attack. They are not timid.
Coming up a throw, triple loop. Nicely done.
Overhead switching to a star lift.
They look very comfortable out there. They look like they're taking their time on each element. Final move, the back outside death spiral. What a performance. Good for them.
How great that was. They're such solid skaters. They have worked consistently, steadily. There's Jason Dungeon, his other coaches, Johnny Johns and Mitch Moyer in the background. A satisfying performance because they completed their technique. They did not go beyond themselves. And what a nice result for them.
Ina and Zimmerman, well, they got to wait and see if it's enough. I'm not so sure it is. They're in first place, the current leaders. But Danielle and Steve Hartzell will hear their marks. Did they capture the gold medal? We'll find out when we return. Danielle and Steve Hartzell waiting to find out if they have indeed won the gold medal.
And this was the wonderful throw triple Saukow that they did in the program. Good lift, good control. Not a whole lot of height in this, but very much in control and good speed in the landing.
They're not as elegant. They're not as graceful as some of the other pairs. But the steadiness of their technique, as represented in this march, is just first rate.
They won a bronze medal last year. They won a junior world championship in 1997. Now the second set of marks for presentation.
5.7, 5.6.
In a wide range, but those are good enough, Dick. Danielle and Steve Hartzell are the new U.S. pairs champions. They edge out Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman. Kyoko knows both sides of it. The two-time and, until moments ago, reigning U.S. champion along with Jason Dungeon. And now she'll settle for the silver medals. And there's Georgia Hartzell, Danielle and Steve's mother.
Those are happy tears.
The championship pairs competition. But stay with us now, because in just a few minutes, you'll be meeting...
So for the first time, Danielle and Steve Hartzell will stand on top of the podium wearing gold. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman settle for the silver. And it's Laura Handy and J. Paul Benabo, surprisingly, capturing the bronze medal. That is a great U.S. national championship for them. And the rest here in the Paris Free Skate. By the way, the last brother and sister team to win the U.S. title, Kitty and Peter Carruthers, back in 1984. Guess where it was? Right here in Salt Lake City. And they were inducted into the USFSA Hall of Fame this week here in town.